I'm sure we've all been there on a tight deadline, scouring the internet for any effects or assets that could give your motion graphics or animation or editing project that special little something that you just don't have the time to create yourself. Well, if you have been there, then this bundle from AEJuice might just be the answer to your problems. Or maybe not, hence the title. Totally honest, no BS review. You guys know me, I'll always give it to you straight. And at the end of the video, there is going to be a giveaway for you guys. So if you like free stuff as much as I do, which is a lot, stick around. Let's take a look at what's really important here. What exactly do you get in this I Want It All bundle? And is it actually good shit? Is it even worth it? Well, you do get a ridiculous amount of stuff in this bundle. Sound effects, a bunch of different visual effects assets, transitions, pre-animated stuff, text animators, presets. There are over 30,000 animated assets in this library, in over 300 different categories. I mean, I could list them all for you in this video, but I'm not out here trying to waste your guys' time. I'm trying to save you time. With this bundle, you work smarter, not harder. And all this stuff is really easy to customize and work with, so no worries about spending hours trying to figure out how to make it work or tweak it so it suits your project's look and feel. This is the pack manager, and I love how it makes everything really simple and quick to use and search for, and you can see exactly what each effect is really easily. In this left-hand side window, you can just click on a specific effect if you want to just jump right to it. Now this tab here is the starter pack, with basic stuff that you might find yourself using quite often in your projects. Stuff that, yes, might be simple to create yourself, but when it's crunch time, you know, it's just more efficient to use pre-made assets that you can quickly tweak, like these dope frame-by-frame elements. There are controls for you to edit things like colors, duration, blending mode, and of course you can add any other effects you might want to the comp to further tweak it to your needs. Or you can go down into the nested comps and tweak things from there, you just need to know what you're doing so you don't break anything. The world, or this bundle at least, is your oyster. And this starter pack is one of their free assets that you can get off their site, so get it! In the I Want It All bundle, like I already said, you get everything available on their site from AEJuice. There is stuff from third parties, like courses and stuff that you don't get, but everything from AEJuice you do get. So there's way more cool stuff right here in the products tab of the pack manager that you can download as part of the bundle. Some of the stuff here is legitimately really cool. There's too much for me to go through everything in this video. I value your time and my own, so I'll show you guys some of my ultimate favorites. Oh, by the way, I'm going to be showing you around all of this in After Effects, but you can use these in Premiere Pro too, so bonus. So let's take a look at these liquid elements. If I just scroll down here, you can see how many there are. On the website, they said like 1,000 plus, I think. Yep, more than 1,000. That's what is mathematically termed a crapload. You've got these angel wings, arrows which are used all the time in animated infographics, chaos loops. Oh, that reminds me of Arcane with Jinx's scribbles and effects they comp in when she's losing her shit. Anyway, a bunch of other stuff as well, explosions, fire loops, so many things. So let's use one. I've got this girl standing here. She's got a cigarette and I'm gonna add some smoke to the cigarette. If you go to the bottom right-hand corner there, there are a bunch of options for you. So you can play around with those, see what they do. They're pretty self-explanatory if you hover over them. This one here is really cool, the settings icon, because if you click on it, you see there's options for changing the style of the effect. You can add a drop shadow or a glow or a texture or other styles really easily, which is dope. I want the smoke to have a stroke as the style because that's the look and feel of the design that I'm bringing this effect into. So in settings, I select stroke, then say okay. Then I'm gonna drag this effect into my comp. Something to note is that the effect comp will start wherever your time indicator is in your timeline. So just make sure it's where you want it to be when you add it. Obviously, it's really easy to fix once it's in there. It's just one of those things where if you can avoid that extra step of adjusting it after adding it, why not? So now I've got this animated smoke going on here. And I'll just scale it down. Move it to where I want it to be. Then I parent it to the hand bone so it moves as the hand moves. And it's that easy. You can obviously take this further and as the hand moves, you can add a little mesh warp so it bends and whatever, but you know, this is the crux of it. Now you've got editing options over here. These options vary depending on what effect you're using, and you're not only limited to these options if you know your way around After Effects. Obviously, you can go into the comp and nested comps and delve a bit deeper. That's what I did with the intro title you guys saw. So you've got the power. These are just surface level controls for convenience. But if you need more editing power, you can go in and change pretty much whatever you want to. The comps are set up really neatly and are easy to work with and figure out. The pack that I used for the intro was the Cartoon Comics pack, which is another one that I really like. The comic aesthetic is totally my vibe. Like I said, there were a few things that I wanted to change and play around with there, like repositioning some of the text and duplicating and tweaking some of the effects, tweaking the colors, and it was really easy to work with, and it was at least 10 times faster than if I'd had to create and animate each element myself. Again, there are tons of options, so let's look at using and editing one for our own purposes. I'm going to bring in one that says write your any text, and you'll see over here in the pack manager now, I have all these options to tweak and edit the text and its sizes and colors. You can also turn the shadow on and off and adapt things like the rotation, scale, position, and anchor point of the different words, change the blending mode, and even add music. So I'm going to change the text to something else. I like the way you work it, no diggity. Okay, now let's change the colors of the accent elements. Let's go with a nice purple. Now we can make adjustments to the text with these controls, but one thing I do have an issue with is that once you've updated the text, these controls retain the names of the old text. They don't update to reflect the new text you've put in, which can get confusing. But anyway, let's make some adjustments to the text. I'm going to increase the scale of the words I like and then change the color. Let's change all the text colors. And you see you can adjust the rotation and skew as well. And there you go. Obviously you can add other elements to this, other text or transitions, a background, but you can see it's all really easy to use and change. One other thing that is a little annoying is how long you have to wait when you want to add a new effect to your comp, like one you haven't used before. Is this checking for updates? You have to wait a little while, and when I'm in the zone and getting stuff done as fast as I can, this does get irritating. Yes, I've gotten used to and now expect instant gratification, but that's the fast-paced world we're living in, okay? But to be fair, it still saves me way more time than making the stuff costs me, so, you know, I just keep reminding myself of that trade-off. So I've showed you guys stuff you can use for your motion graphics and animation work, but let's take a look at transitions and more sort of editing and video and footage stuff. A really cool thing I discovered, which I didn't expect, is this category for Pixels videos, which is royalty-free and most of it is under the Creative Commons Zero license. So you get some video footage here that you can use, and I'll use this for demonstrating how to use some of these transitions and effects. So I've got some footage here that I brought in from this Pixels video pack, laid them on the timeline, and now I'm going to add some transitions and video effects. Let's first do a transition from this Glitch Transitions pack. I'm just going to select the footage that I want to transition to here in the timeline, then select the effect here in the pack that I want to use, then just click Animate. And there it is. A transition between the two overlapping clips. Now for this one, I think I'll add some animated markers. So with this piece of footage, because there is a bit of movement on the camera, I want the markers to move with the camera's motion. So I've tracked it and I applied the tracking information to this null, which I will then parent these markers to. So they're already animated, but I'm also adding a bit more dimension by having them move with the camera too. So I'll bring in a few of these markers. There we go, position and scale them where I want them. And then parent them to this now that has the tracking information on it. And you see now they move with the camera and it looks really cool with the animation that was originally on them as well as moving with the camera. So I'll add another transition here from one of the other packs. I'll first select the footage in the timeline, then go to the Seamless Transitions pack and I'll just pick one there. And I'll hit Animate and there you go. We've got the seamless transition between the two clips and of course it's adjustable with the markers here. You can also edit a few things if we go over to the Pack Manager window. I want it a little more trippy, so I'm going to check the box for neon light and then chromatic aberration because I just love that effect, and then also glow. I think that looks pretty rad. And now on this last clip, I'm going to add some texture. So if I go over here, we've got this really cool urban texture pack. I'm going to select the footage on the timeline, select the texture I want to add, then click Animate. Now we have the texture in the comp here, and over here we've got some controls. So I'm going to uncheck black and white, and I'm going to play around here with the color, and I'm going to set it to add. And then in the timeline, I'll lower the opacity of the comp with the texture. And now we have a really cool texture overlay on our footage, making it a little more gritty. It's really awesome how many packs and possibilities you have to play around with here. I mean, you even get free sound effects in this bundle. You see over here in the store, if you scroll way down under free, there are these other free effects you get, and then we have sound effects. Let's open up the tab and check out what you get. We've got alarms, beatbox sounds, bells, book drops, chimes, some cinematic sounds. Well, that is pretty cinematic. So many options. Icons, you even get some music, sub drops. There's so much stuff here, and remember, these are free and they're professional quality shit. If you were to go and buy these from a sound library, it would be a lot of money. And it can be difficult finding some of these more subtle effects. And if you're the kind of person who usually tries to find free sound effects under a Creative Commons license, well, good luck with finding good quality ones, or even finding what you need. It's amazing that you get all of these and for free, so I just had to mention that. So all in all, my no BS opinion on this pack is that it is legitimately awesome and you get a ton of really genuinely useful stuff in it. The effects are easy to customize and adapt. The pack manager makes using the effects and finding out what you need really easy, and having this pack will speed up your workflow. You can use it in After Effects and Premiere Pro. There's a wide range of effects available for various uses and projects, whether you're more on the motion graphics and animation side or more into editing and doing vlogs and stuff with footage. There are different options for this bundle, so you can buy a lifetime license or there are monthly and yearly licenses. So right now, as of recording this video, the I Want It All bundle, the lifetime version, is $149 with their New Year sale. So that is definitely worth it for what you get in this bundle. That's an amazing deal. I don't know what the price is going to be when this video goes live, but you know, if that sale is still on, you might want to just jump on it. Now to the nitty gritty, you know, the honest part of this review. It's not just all sunshine and roses. There were a couple of minor things that I did have an issue with. The first being the waiting when you drop a new effect into your comp. And I admit that I am impatient, and it's a tiny negative when you look at all the stuff you get in this pack, but it does get a little irritating when you're trying to use a lot of the stuff and you're in a big rush. And then there's also the fact that with the text elements, when you change the text, the controls don't update with the new text. So you either have to try to remember what it used to be or keep scrolling up to check over here, you know, this text changed to this text, which can also get a little bit annoying when you're in a rush. So that's also a little drawback because you can get confused about what text you're editing. But all in all, this is a super sick bundle with hundreds of useful effects and assets that will help you out in your projects. All the effects and animations you've seen in this video are from elements in this bundle. Now don't get too excited. Okay, get excited, because this is awesome. I've got three different giveaways for you guys. The first one is a lifetime license to the I Want It All bundle. So yes, that's everything that I've just shown you in this video. I have one to give away for free to one of you. The second giveaway is a 20% discount on any purchase on the AEJuice site. And the third giveaway is a 10% discount on any purchase on the AEJuice site. There is a link in the description of this video for you guys to go and check out the I Want It All bundle, or to go and peruse the site and see what other offerings they have on there on AEJuice.com. The winner will be chosen randomly through a generator. All you need to do to qualify for this giveaway is to first comment on this video with what you think the best thing about the bundle is, or what in this bundle you think would most benefit you with what you do and the sort of projects that you're working on. The second thing you need to do is share this video on a social media platform like Facebook or Twitter or Instagram. Don't forget to tag me in it, otherwise I won't know that you've shared it. So if you want to see what my handles are, if you look in the banner of my channel in the bottom right hand corner, there are links to my socials, so you can go there and see what to tag me as, just so I can see that you have actually shared the video there. And third, subscribe to the AEJuice YouTube channel, which I will also put a link to in the description of this video. Thanks for watching, everybody, and thank you massively to my patrons who've been super understanding in this time when I have not been uploading as much as usual and keeping you guys updated, because I've been, you know, putting most of my energy into building a baby and I've also got a full-time job and I get a lot of fatigue, so it's difficult to balance the YouTube channel and that stuff as well. So I do massively appreciate it. Give the video a like and subscribe if you want to keep up to date with my other videos, if that floats your boat. Bye!